Hello, BookTube. Well, I'm slightly recovered from the last video because I have moved from the main room into this little book library of mine, this little bed library. I chose a small room at the back of the house, put a bed underneath the window for the very small amount of sleeping that I do, and it's perfectly fine for the dogs who are on it right now, and then just filled the rest of the room with bookshelves from floor to ceiling. So it's like having a bed in a library, which is really nice. And the air conditioner is right there in the window, so the room is, it's a very small air conditioner, it's a cute little thing, and the room is so small that it makes it perfectly, magically comfortable. So I'm here, and I situated up the camera, and I think it all looks okay. I mean, you've still got a background crammed full of books. And I thought, since I'm feeling collected, we would do a little mail haul. I can't believe that my afternoon mail truck driver, Tom from Tipperary, I can't believe that he was hauling his lily-white Irish skin around in this weather. But he was, and he brought me a small shipment. I thought we'd go through it together. Yes, for some reason, I feel like I've been neglecting you. I looked at my BookTube video feed, and I haven't been, but it still feels that way. I don't know why. So anyway, my channel, I can make an extra video if I want, can't I? It's not Trump America yet. So let's see. Let's see what this is. Oh, okay. This is, we've done this before. We saw the ARC of this, The Virginity of Famous Men, by Christine Sneed. I must confess, I have not yet read the ARC, so that always functions as a kind of gentle reminder to get to it. Needless to say, this will come as no surprise to you if you watch this channel. Collections of short stories generally don't rocket to the head of my priority. Let's see what this is. Oh my! See, it's been bumped again. This is In the Land of the Giants. This is A Journey Through the Dark Ages by Max Adams. Oh my. Oh, very good. The five centuries between the end of Roman Britain and the death of Alfred the Great have left few voices save a handful of chronicles, but Britain's dark ages can still be explored through their material remnants, architecture, books, metalwork, and above all, landscapes. Oh, very nice. Okay, that comes out in October, when I can only assume the heat dome will be lifted. Feels like a permanent part of life now, but it's not supposed to last past tonight. What else have we got here? This is Eterna and Omega by Liana Renee Heber. Don't know it at all. Don't know what this is at all. This is from Tor, which I highly encourage. If you're watching, you nice people at Tor, I'm always happy to get books from you. This comes out in the first week of August, and it is her latest gas lamp fantasy. In New York City, fearing the dangers of the Eterna compound, supposedly the key to immortality, Clara Templeton buries information vital to its creation. The ghost of her clandestine lover is desperate to tell her she is wrong, but though she is clairvoyant, she cannot hear him. I seem to remember reading about the Eterna compound. I think I read the book that came before this. The Eterna Files. I'll have to check my reading journal and see. Then we've got a little item from the Historical Novel Review. For those of you who are new, and my God, there are hundreds of you who are, I am the U.S. and worldwide editor for the indie branch of the Historical Novel Society's review site. Which means I deal with self-published historical novels everywhere except the UK. So that's what this is. I get submissions all the time from this. This is The Brother's Path by Martha Kennedy. A solid, understated cover. The cover, you can't really tell. The only reason I'm bringing it up is because I've just run up against it. The cover is slightly out of focus. And you look at it and you think, well, you know, poetic license, and it adds a certain mystique. But the whole thing, from front and back, is slightly out of focus. So the cover, the copy is difficult to read, but it's set in the world of the Protestant Reformation. So we'll give that a try. We'll add that to the historical novel review pile. And then the last one for today is this thing. Okay. We've saw this before as well. This is almost all reprints. This is The King's Revenge. This is a new history of the revenge that Charles II took on the men who murdered his father. And it comes out in very early August. It might actually be in bookstores already. This is the finished copy. I got the ARC. So this has about 10 pages of black and white illustrations inside. Good. All right, so we have a self-published historical novel, English history, gas lamp fantasy, more English history, and a collection of short stories. Not bad, especially in the middle of a heat dome. So I'll be back soon. Book two. Thank you.